What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about how you can make those nice blurry background photos on your iPhone. I'm sure we're all familiar with what professional looking photos look like of people, at least, where the subject is nice, sharp, and in focus, and the background is nice, creamy, and bokeh out or blurry. And that's nice and all, and we know the cameras that can do that, but most of us don't really have $2,000 to $4,000 to drop on that. So luckily for us, our phones in our pockets can create that effect really nice and easily, especially on the iPhone. And there are three simple ways to do that. Okay, so the first and easiest way to achieve this effect is through the iPhone's portrait mode, which is built right into the native camera app, which is extremely convenient. So go ahead and open up the camera app right on your iPhone, swipe down below to portrait mode, and then the phone will pretty much do the rest of the work for you. All you gotta do is just have your subject or the person you wanna take a photo of be between 2 to 8 feet of your phone. And if you don't really know what 2 to 8 feet looks like when you're eyeballing it, the phone will tell you if your subject is either too close or a little bit too far, and it doesn't look as professional as you want it to, and the background doesn't look as blurred. What's also pretty cool about the portrait mode on the iPhone is that there's different kinds of modes within it, like natural light or even studio light, so go ahead and mess around with those. I think the effects get pretty cool if you can get creative with it. The second way that you could achieve this effect is also super simple, and you could do it through the app called Snapseed. Snapseed is a wonderful app because you can open it up, import any photo you want, doesn't have to be taken on portrait mode. Go ahead, click tools down below, and click on lens blur. Lens blur will open up a little area that in the middle leaves very sharp, but everything outside of that area effect is all blurred out. So go ahead, pinch, zoom in, do whatever you want to achieve a nice concentrated look so that you could lead your viewer's eyes towards where you want it to be in this landscape or in this portrait photo that you have. All right, so you might have been following along in this tutorial and you start ripping out a lot of photos in portrait mode or just using Snapseed a lot, and you just end up with a lot of photos that are extremely similar with only slight tweaks, like you moved around just a little bit. So that could get pretty problematic because you could lose and take up a lot of storage from doing that. So I highly recommend using this app called Gemini Photos, which you can download through the link in the description down below. And Gemini Photos is super cool because if you have a lot of similar photos, with the AI software like built into the app, it knows all the duplicates that are in your photo library. It'll categorize it all into one bucket. You can just go on ahead and just delete whatever you want, and sometimes it'll even recommend what the best photo from that batch was. It can also detect blurry photos or even unwanted screenshots, so Gemini Photos can do it all for you. Just go in and kind of delete what you want, keep what you want, and highly recommend using it. So go ahead and download it in the description down below and you really won't regret it. The third and final way that you could achieve this effect is through Photoshop Express. So go ahead, open up the app, import any photo that you want, go through adjustments, and then click on the tool called Blur. And then go ahead, have fun adjusting with that. Make sure you save all the adjustments and then export it as a JPEG, and then you are all good to go.